excited to talk to you because I am going to be talking to you all about crystals, my journey with crystals, and how and why they work. So let's get started. All right, now to start this video off, I want to give a big thank you to our sponsor, which is Keen. I have partnered with Keen in the past, so you guys might be familiar. They are giving a very special offer for you today, which is your first 3 minutes for free. So Keen is an online platform where you can connect with spiritual advisors, psychics, mediums, tarot card readers, astrologers, etc. online, and then you can either chat with them on the phone or via computer. So Keen actually gives you the opportunity to go through a type of little quiz once you enter onto the site to help align you best with the psychic advisor that you are presently seeking. So if there's specific guidance you're wondering about, maybe it's spiritual guidance, maybe it's love and relationship guidance, or maybe it's simply a tarot card reading. By going through the quiz, you can take the time to get clear on what it is you're looking for, and then Keen will match you up. Keen is also amazing in the way that after you do sign up and have a call with an advisor, they'll keep you posted via emails with special discounts and offers as time goes on. The one thing that I truly appreciate about Keen is that you can connect with all different advisors. So for example, if there's an advisor that you really like, you can build a relationship with them and keep coming back whenever you're feeling in need of any type of spiritual guidance or just desiring a reading of some kind. And also that if you are on the call with someone and you just don't feel like you're connecting, you don't have to sit there for a period of time, like half an hour or whatever amount of time it is you are seeking. If you're not clicking with someone right away, there's tons of other advisors for you to check out. So I encourage you guys to take advantage of the special offer of your first 3 minutes for free from Keen. The link will be down below. So let's get into today's Law of Attraction Tuesday video, which is all about crystals. So if you were to ask me about 10 years ago if I would be someone who would be into crystals or like have crystals, I could tell you guys no. I was not like that. I did not gravitate towards them. You know, I was able to recognize that crystals are pretty, rocks are pretty, I like nature, that type of stuff. But I started to develop a relationship or an appreciation for crystals the more I got into spirituality. When I was going through that phase of moving to Rome, a few months before moving to Rome, there's actually a spirituality store which was right near my house, and I started to go into it more often, flip through some books, and they also had an abundance of different types of crystals. So I started to get a little bit interested in them. I started to appreciate their beauty a lot more. I started to ask the store owner a lot of questions about crystals, and I was able to notice that there were certain crystals that I would gravitate towards. And when I would go into the store, I would choose an intention. So for example, that intention could be financial abundance. And then I would see which crystal I was drawn to in that moment. So personally, I'm gonna show you guys two crystals today. So I have an amethyst crystal. This is a purple one that's quite popular. And this is just to decrease anxiety. That's what most people use it for. It's just a calming energy. And I also have love quartz. So this one actually just promotes love, the heart chakra healing, and attracts love into your life. Upon choosing both of these crystals, I was drawn to both of them in the store. So when you go into a crystal store, you might notice, wow, there's so many to choose from. Which one do I choose? So I personally like to pick them up and see if I'm feeling any type of vibes from them. It depends how in tune you are with energy or if you even believe in that, right? If that's gonna work for you. But I just kind of choose which one I'm gravitating towards. And I also decide that I'm going to set an intention upon going to the crystal store. I set intentions for everything, and that's part of like Law of Attraction. As you guys know, intentions can be everything sometimes. So typically when I do go into a crystal store, I set the intention of what I'm looking for. So for example, when I did pick up this rose quartz, I went into that crystal store saying, I'm going to choose a crystal that represents unconditional love. And that's going to support me along that journey of unconditional self-love and unconditional love for all of those around me. So upon going into that store, there was of course a lot of these little heart-shaped rose quartz, but that's the one that I just felt drawn to. And choose the one that you just feel drawn to because that's the one that's gonna feel the most magical and most special to you. So crystals have all different meanings behind them. Like I showed you, amethyst reduces anxiety, promotes calmness and ease, things like that. So they're all different. But whatever you believe to be true will be true for you. And like I just spoke about intentions, if you're setting the intention that your amethyst crystal is going to reduce your anxiety, that's naturally gonna happen to you because it's part of your belief system. As you know with the Law of Attraction, whatever you believe will manifest. whether you like it or not. So for example, if you believe that rose quartz is going to draw unconditional love for you, you're having that intention in your presence. For me personally, I keep that crystal in my bedroom window. So oftentimes when I'm shutting my blinds before I'm about to go to sleep, I just notice that crystal and subconsciously I'm already thinking about unconditional love and how that's in my space and how that surrounds me and that's how I treat myself. So by having crystals around, it's almost like you have these intentions just there to remind you to go back to what you need, what supports you. And that's why they work for me personally, is because I've attached this belief to them that amethyst reduces my anxiety and promotes positive energy, and my love quartz attracts love energy to me and promotes unconditional love. So there's a lot of information about crystals out there and their magical powers. If you're someone who likes to believe in the magic of life like I do, that's why I find them so fascinating and so interesting, and that's why I'm kind of drawn to them or want to learn more about them, like where they come from in the world and why people or the ancient civilizations believe they were good for this or good for that. And I find it to be just an interesting topic to research. So I encourage you guys to dive a little bit deeper on that, dive a little bit deeper into what crystal might serve you best in this moment. So for example, let's say you are seeking financial abundance in 2020. A good crystal for that is called citrine. It's a yellow crystal. And what you can do is you can learn a little bit more about it. You can set the intention that when you do get citrine, this is going to attract financial abundance to you. They almost act as your good luck charms, and they will then attract what it is that you're seeking because you're setting the intentions that that is the role that this crystal is going to play in your life. So they are essentially a fun manifestation tool, a fun self-improvement, a fun self-love, self-supportive tool. I personally, like I said, like to believe that they contain magic powers because they're all my good luck charms, and I do keep them out in the windowsill to absorb the moon's energy, absorb the sun's energy, and just promote positivity in my home. I also like to use them when I have my new moon and full moon intentions or letting go ceremonies, and I just find it's very positive and beautiful to just look at them. They are beautiful. Whatever you visualize must materialize. So by you consciously setting these intentions, consciously surrounding your space with positive reminders everywhere, you will attract abundance into your life in whatever form you are seeking. I'm wishing you guys an abundant, positive rest of your week, and I'll see you again tomorrow. Bye!